So you already feel confident with GA4 UI, and now it's time to get insights, and we will do that with the help of explorations. In this video, we'll have a look at different techniques and we'll create our first report using Free-form. So let's dive into it. So we have already covered standard reports, and this is where you can see some basic information about user activity on your web page. But let's say you have some specific questions you would love to answer with your data. And this is where we can use the explore section. So let's explore together. And here you can create your new custom report, and it will be saved automatically to the list below. And I'm working with a Google Demo account. This is why you can see Google Merchandise Store. And let's have a look here. We have different techniques. So you can start with a blank exploration, creating everything from scratch, or you can use some pre-configured techniques. And in this way, you can analyze your data from different angles using a set of common dimensions and metrics. So the first one is Free-form, and this is a classical cross-tab layout, and we will have a look at it in a moment. Then we also have funnel exploration, and in this way you can identify the steps your users take on your webpage, for example, to a specific conversion. The next one is path exploration, and in this way you can visualize how your users are navigating your webpage and how they are interacting with your content. Let's move to the next one, and it's segment overlap, and it can help you identify how different groups of your users relate to each other. Here we have cohort exploration, and this is about groups of users who share some common characteristics. Let's say you select acquisition date, and in this way you can have a look at your users visited your site or application for the first time on a specific date, and you can identify some trends in this way. And we have user lifetime here, and in this way you can have a look and determine the value of users over their lifetime as your customers. And again, I'm using Google Demo account, and this is why I do not see one more technique, which is called User Explorer. And it's a cool one, because in this way you can drill into individual user activity, but it's not displayed here due to some privacy regulations, because it's a demo account. But anyways, let's go back to our Free-form. And here you can see the layout. We have two columns on the left and this table on the right side. And basically here you set everything up. This is where you configure everything. And on the right, you can see the result of your configuration, the output of your setup. And let's have a look at columns. Here we have the first one with the exploration name, so we can provide the name. So let's say test custom report. You can also choose the time frame. So let's say I want to work with the data for the last week. And let's click apply. And here we have segments. So basically, these are subsets of your users, and you can work with users from the United States, for example. And you can also add those here. Then we have dimensions and metrics. So as you can see, these are the components of your report, or so-called building blocks. And dimensions are green and metrics are blue. So basically, dimensions are the aspect of your business you want to analyze, and metrics help us measure. And let's move to the second column. And here we have techniques. So we have already covered that one. You can also select visualization method. So here we have table, donut chart, or geomap. So you can choose the one that would be the most suitable for a specific report. Here you can add your segments for analysis. And we have rows and columns with dimensions and values with metrics. And here we have filters where you can drop or select specific dimensions or metrics to filter out your data. Here, if you want to include or exclude something. And let's say you want to work with specific dimension or metric. How is it possible if we can have only these ones here? You can add your dimension. So let's say I want to have also first user source, because here I can see the medium, but I want to have the source. So I would have to click plus, and here you can see the list of dimensions. And I would definitely recommend checking Google documentation, because it might be a bit challenging to remember everything. So just make sure that you know what specific dimension or metric means. And let's type first user source. And here we go. Just select it and let's click import, and it will pop up here. Okay, so now we can build our first simple report. So let me delete everything that was pre-configured here. And let's say I want to see all the events that are taking place on my web page, and I also want to see the event count. So how can I do that? We can select the event name, and we can drag and drop it, or simply double click this way. And then if we select metrics, we should choose the event count, and we can also double click. And I have to say, this is super convenient to double click, love it. And here we can also sort the event count. And in this way, you can see the events and here the number of those events. So we created a super simple report, and you can get the idea how it works. So let's say I also want to add the second dimension, and I just want to see the country. So you can also drag and drop it here, and now you can also see the countries. So in this way, you can add second dimensions. But let's just delete everything here, and let me create a different report. So let's say I want to see my first user source, and I want to see also the event count for it, as well as transactions. So what should I do? I should select my first user source, and I will double click because it's super convenient. And then we also have event count as well as transactions. And here we go. In this way, we created our report, and we can also add filters. So let's say I want to work with Baidu only. So I will click drop select dimensions, first user source, and I will say contains and Baidu. And here you can click apply, for example. Or let's say I want to exclude Baidu or Bing, let's say. So I would click here, first user source, and here I would select does not contain, and I would say Bing. And let's click apply. And in this way, you can exclude Bing from the report. And just one thing here, you can create multiple conditions in your filters, and they are also AND conditions. Yeah, so these two conditions must be fulfilled at the same time. Okay, so let me delete this one. And let's have a look at this table. So this is our simple report. And if you click plus here, you can create a new exploration. You can also undo the changes or redo. You can share your reports by clicking here. And in this way, you can also send the report to your colleagues or to your customers. So I know this might be a bit challenging in the very beginning, but you should practice. And the more reports you create, the more confident you will feel doing this. So have fun exploring the reports. So this is the end of our short course for beginners, yet the beginning of your GA4 adventure. So keep growing, keep exploring, have fun using this tool. And you can check our GA4 videos right here. And see you next time.